Alright, so now let's go through our example of our Fourier approximation of our piecewise defined function. So first we'll do a restart and open the plots package, and then we'll put in our function. So our function is -7 for x in between negative pi and 0, and +7 for x in between 0 and pi. So just to get a plot, we see that we have this square wave graph that has an amplitude of 7. Now let's look at calculating the first few Fourier coefficients. So we saw the setup before this video. Here's the maple code to do the integral for a_0. a_0 comes out to be 0. Well, that's because we're doing the integral of an odd function from negative pi to pi. We'll also do a_1 and b_1. So a_1 comes out to be 0, b_1 becomes 28 over pi. So we can now do our first degree Fourier polynomial and see what it looks like. So our first degree Fourier polynomial will be a_0 plus a_1 times cosine of x plus b_1 times sine of x. Because of the zeros in a_1 and a_0, our polynomial only looks like 28 sine x over pi. Now if we plot that with our function, we don't get a very good approximation, but you can see how it does start to model the shape of the graph we were given. Now, because it's just a slight modification in our code to do more coefficients, in other words, I want to find a_2, the only difference is I have to put a 2 in my argument of cosine, and b_2 means I put a 2 in my argument of sine, so on and so forth. It's really quick to do the next few coefficients. So here's a_2, a_3, b_2, and b_3. Now notice a_2 and b_2 come out to be 0, so they're not going to add anything to our Fourier approximation, so there's no point in doing a second degree. So we'll go straight to doing a third degree. Now this code here will set up our polynomial. So what we have here is a third degree Fourier polynomial. Let's take a look at the plot. We see that we start to get a better approximation of our behavior here, up where the lines for f of x are. So now let's get a general look at our coefficients, just finding what a_k and b_k look like. a_k turns out to be 0. That's going to happen a lot with Fourier series and Fourier polynomials, because we deal a lot with even and odd functions, and when you're taking the antiderivative or the integral of an odd function over an interval that's symmetric around 0, then the integral will come out to be 0. We see that our b_k's are all going to have this form here. Now, since k is an integer, cosine is always going to be some integer. We're always taking the cosine of some integer multiple of pi. Cosine of pi is negative 1. Cosine of 2 pi is negative 1. There's 1. So on and so forth. So what's going to happen is it's going to oscillate between 0 and 28 for the b coefficients. So, for instance, we can set up the ninth degree polynomial very quickly, noticing this pattern. So here's our ninth degree polynomial plotted with f of x. You'll have a chance to look at this code later as well. I'm going to post this on the website so you can look at the code a little bit more explicitly. Now, just some other things that we can do. We can put in some code so the coefficients can be written as sequences. That's what this code does here. And notice that I'm using L equals 2 pi. I'm going to talk a little bit more about this later in the lesson, but that's if we have an interval that, what if we want to do something over an interval that's pi or an interval that's 6? L can be anything. So we're just doing 2 pi for now. Sorry, let's restart. Here's our function. And so written as sequences, we can actually just have P go through 1 through 5 in this case and get the next 5 coefficients. So let's do a whole bunch more. So now we're going to go through the first 21 Fourier coefficients. And with this as sequences, it turns out we can calculate them really quick. We can then use the sum command to create our Fourier polynomial. So g of x looks like this. So we have our 21st degree Fourier polynomial. And if we plot that with f of x, we see we get a really good approximation. Last thing really quick, quick little animation showing the convergence, and we get a nice approximation.